गुड मॉर्निंग गाइज, माई नेम इज़ शिवेन अस्थाना। आई एम अ सेकेंड ईयर लॉ स्टूडेंट फ्रॉम विप्स IIT दिल्ली एंड एन इंटर्न एट लेक्सिस एंड कंपनी। एंड टुडे आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट द टॉपिक ऑफेंसेज अगेंस्ट द स्टेट। सेक्शन 121 टू सेक्शन 130 डील्स विद द ऑफेंसेज कमिटेड अगेंस्ट द स्टेट। सो व्हाट इज सेक्शन 121? सेक्शन 121 इज वेजिंग और अटेम्प्टिंग टू वेज वॉर और अबेटिंग वेजिंग ऑफ वॉर अगेंस्ट द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया। So whosoever wages war against the government of India or attempts to wage such war or abets the waging of such war shall be punished with death or imprisonment for life and shall be also liable to fine. Example, A joins an insurrection against the government of India. A has committed the offense defined in the section. Section 121A, conspiracy to commit offenses punishable by section 121. Whoever within or without India conspires to commit any offense punishable by the section 121 or conspires to overrave by means of criminal force or the show of criminal force the central government or any state government shall be punished with imprisonment for life or with imprisonment of either description which may extend to 10 years and shall also be liable to fine. So to constitute a conspiracy under this section, it is not necessary that any act or illegal omission shall make place in pursuance thereof. Section 122, collecting arms, etc. with the intention of waging war against the government of India. So whosoever collects men, arms or ammunition or otherwise prepares to wage war against the government of India with the intention of either waging or being prepared to wage war against the government shall be punished with imprisonment for life and imprisonment of either description for a term not exceeding 10 years but I'll also be liable to fine. Section 123, concealing with intent to facilitate design to wage war. Whosoever by any act or by any legal omission conceals the existence of a design to wage war against the government of India, intending by such concealment to facilitate or knowing it to be likely that such concealment will facilitate the waging of such war shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 10 years and shall also be liable to fine. Section 124, assaulting president, governor, etc. with the intent to compel or restrain the exercise of any lawful power. Whosoever with the intention of including or compelling the president of India or governor of any state to exercise or refrain from exercising in any matter, in manner or any of the lawful powers of such president or governor, assault or wrongfully restrains or attempt wrongfully to restrain or overraves by means of criminal force or the show of criminal force or attempts to overwave such president, governor, shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 7 years and shall also be liable to fine. Section 124A, sedition. Whosoever by words, either written or spoken or by signs or by visible representation or otherwise, brings or attempts to bring into hatred or contempt or excites or attempts to excite disaffection towards the government established by law in India shall be punished with imprisonment for life, which may be added, or with imprisonment, which may extend to 3 years, to which may be fine be added. Explanation for this is the explanation disaffection includes disloyalty and all feelings of enmity. Explanation 2. Comments expressing disapprobation of the measures from the government with a view to obtain their alteration by lawful means without exciting or attempting to excite hatred, contempt or disaffection to do not constitute any offence under this section. Section 125, waging war against any Asiatic power in alliance with the government of India. Whosoever wages war against the government of any Asiatic power in alliance with the present government or abets the waging of such war shall be punished with imprisonment for life, to which may be fine be added, with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 7 years, to which fine may be added, or with fine. Section 126, committing depredation on territories of power at peace with the government of India. Whosoever commits depredation or makes preparation to commit depredation on the territories of any power in alliance or at peace with the government of India shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 7 years and shall also be liable to fine. Section 127, receiving property taken by war on depredation mentioned in under section 125 and 126. Whosoever receives any property knowing that the same have to be given same to be have been taken in the commission of any offences mentioned in 126 and 126 section shall be punished with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 7 years and shall also be liable to fine and to forfeiture the property so received. Section 128, public servant voluntarily allowing person, prisoner of state or war to escape, whoever public being a public servant and having the custody of any state prisoner or prisoner of war, voluntarily allow such prisoners to escape any place in which this such prisoner is confined, shall be punished with imprisonment for life or imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 10 years with fine. Section 129, public servant negligently suffering such prisoner to escape, whosoever has been a public servant, being a public servant and having the custody of that state prisoner or prisoner of war, negligently suffers such prisoners to escape from any place of confinement with such prisoner is confined, shall be punished with simple imprisonment for a term which may extend to 3 years and shall also be liable to fine. The last section, 120, 730, section 130, aiding escape of rescuing or harboring such prisoner. Whoever knowingly aids or assists state prisoner or prisoner of war in escaping from lawful custody or rescues or attempts to rescue any such prisoner or harbors or conceals any such prisoner who has escaped from lawful custody shall be punished with imprisonment of life or with imprisonment of either description for a term which may extend to 10 years and shall also be liable to fine. So for this I'll be explaining with an example that a state prisoner or prisoner of war who is permitted to be at large on his parole within certain limits of India is said to escape from lawful custody if he goes beyond the limits of within which he is allowed to be at large, that is outside India. So this was the topic, offences against the state, which were mentioned under section 121 to section 130. I hope you all are clear about this topic right now.